My name is Claire Jantet. I'm a French filmmaker and I have been documenting the stories of Noma patients for several years now, producing a long and a short film. In 2016, when we visited Sokoto for the first time with my colleague at Inedis, Fabrice Caterini, we had never heard about Noma survivors. Noma is a terrible disease. It's preventable and treatable, but still it causes more than 140,000 deaths per year. Many people, I mean 90% of them, are estimated to die within the two first week of the infection. So it's quite shocking. And when you met a Noma patient for the first time, you realize how devastating this disease is. So it gives us the motivation to tell the story of those patients and follow their stories in the hospital and in their villages for several months. They, of course, suffer from mental health issues and physical disabilities, like they have difficulties to breathe or to eat, to speak. So creating a connection with them is something that took quite some time. And we were able to do this after several visits to Sokoto. We met the same patients over and over, and we created a connection with them. So we were able to overcome this first shock of when you meet a Noma patient and start interacting with them and also involve them in the process of making this documentary. Noma survivors change a lot through the process of visiting the hospital of Sokoto. The first change we witnessed was when they arrived at the hospital and they step in and realize that they are not the only one to be affected by the disease. Because they are coming from isolated villages, they think that maybe they are the only ones. And when they realize that this is a real disease and there are other people and even a treatment and the possibility to get the facial reconstruction, it changed already everything for them. In terms of change, I'm also thinking of Mulikat, who is one character of the documentary. She told us in the documentary that she used not to be able even to look at herself in the mirror, and that after getting many surgeries, she has now accepted the way she looks and the way she is in this life, and so she is able to go around, and she even loved to be photographed or filmed. So we created a genuine connection with her. And so thanks to mental health support, nutritional support, and of course the surgical process, patients are able to go back very different from what they were in their villages and communities.